I can't put that out on the air until it's confirmed.
Bulletin, bulletin, this important bulletin just in. Let me see. My goodness, where should I begin? I guess the first thing I should let you know is that this is station HOHO, North Pole Radio. Attention, attention all over the world. I must have the undivided attention of every single boy and girl. We have been informed that a secret meeting is in progress, even as I speak. Wait, wait, an elf named Charlie has been identified as the source of our information leak. It's not often we get a major breaking story of this kind. Let me say again, details are limited at this point in time. Since shortly after last Christmas until earlier this fall, certain suggestions have been made to Santa which could affect us all. It started, from what we understand, when Santa was visited by a big-shot advertising public relations man. Santa, he said, your image is just terrible. Christmas has become old-fashioned and completely out of date. To keep up with the times, there are important changes you're absolutely going to have to make. For example, your sleigh and reindeer delivery system is old and obsolete. I strongly suggest you do away with the entire reindeer fleet. Stand by. Please stand by. I've just been handed important additional information. What a story! What a story! Santa is changing Christmas! Why, it boggles the imagination! I have what appears to be a copy of an official office memo addressed to Santa from the world's largest advertising agency, CCDNO. It was written on October 4. It's stamped Top Secret. Oh, hold on, hold on, there's more! Boys and girls, it's official. It is official. This memo confirms our report is sadly correct. It includes a long list of suggested Christmas changes that Santa must either accept or reject. How could Santa consider making these awful changes? I can't believe it's true. I'm not sure I can, but I'll try my best to read a few. The advertising agency mentioned before, CCDNO, says Santa must get rid of his jolly ho, ho, ho. Between every ho, his belly shakes up and down, making him look like some kind of roly-poly clown. Santa will no longer wear his floppy hats and bright red suits. Gone, too, will be the big black belt and shiny boots. Santa must move from the snowy North Pole. His cheeks are always red and rosy from the wind and cold. So what does it matter, you might wonder why? Well, according to this, the reflection of his rosy cheeks helps put the twinkle in his eye. The old custom of putting out for Santa a glass of milk and cake most certainly will have to end. Santa needs to change his image from plump and round to thin. Santa will not make deliveries down the chimney anymore. To avoid tarnishing his clothes with ashes and soot, Santa will come and go only through a door. Now here's a change I'm sure you'll find most shocking. Santa will no longer have the time to fill and stuff your Christmas stocking. For at least 4 weeks before Christmas, all Santa will do is relax. Instead of visiting with Santa, kids will have to send their Christmas lists in by fax. Because there are just too many kids these days, it's time for Santa to make a policy switch. Santa will personally deliver toys to only the kids of the famous and the rich. Some other arrangements will, of course, be made for all the other girls and boys. Perhaps there will be certain locations where they can simply pick up their Christmas toys. Santa's entire operation needs to be overhauled from what it is today. Everything has got to go. The elves, the reindeer, and most certainly that silly little sleigh. Oh, there is one thing more I should mention right away. You might be wondering how Santa will deliver toys if not by sleigh. From now on, there is a good chance Santa will make his deliveries in a custom-built corporate jet or a souped-up, turbocharged, magic, cherry red Corvette. Wait, wait. The meeting must be ending. I've just been told Santa is coming out, and that an important announcement is most likely pending.
Are you alive? Yes, yes, I think so.
Boys and girls, we're going to have to take you live. Hold on, hold on. I've just been told Santa himself is walking toward the microphone.
Ho, ho, ho. This is Santa. There's not many things in this old world so perfect. They should never change. Right offhand, I can only think of a few. I can't imagine the sky being any other color but blue. Faith and trust, dreams and hopes, hugs and kisses and love are the only other things that come to mind. Oh, and Christmas. Because Christmas is faith and trust and dreams and hopes and hugs and kisses and love all combined. Nevertheless, after thoughtful consideration and careful review, there are a few special things this Christmas I've surely got to do. I've got to put a special shine on my belt and boots. I got to order some brand new floppy hats and several brand new bright red suits. I've got to drink a lot of milk and eat a lot of cake. I'm just not plump enough. My reputation is at stake. My beard is a little short. I need to let it grow. I need to spend some extra time practicing my ho-ho-ho. I've decided there's not a thing about Christmas that's not exactly as it should be. And I'm making doubly sure by leaving an extra lot of faith and trust and dreams and hopes and hugs and kisses and love underneath every Christmas tree. On Christmas morning, when my work is done, I'll relax by the roar of a big open fire, covered from head to foot in ashes and cinders and soot. I don't ever intend to even listen to the big shots anymore. Have you ever heard anything as silly as Santa coming through the door? Merry Christmas, one and all.